Interest targeting and lookalike audiences are the biggest reason you are not successful with your Facebook ads. These targeting options not only hold you back from your potential, but are a crutch that costs you a premium to reach the same audience as everyone else. If you want to begin to win online, then stick around because I'm going to show you exactly how to grow your clothing brand right now. All right, so number four, what is interest targeting? We need to first cover interest targeting and lookalike targeting because this is where everyone goes to and gives advice to online. Honestly, it can still work, but not in the same way as it used to, and not if you want to build a business that lasts a long time. And if you don't want to watch a business or you don't want to grow your business for a long time, then this is probably not for you. So I honestly think that interest targeting could work if you wanted to spend 2 to 3 hours per day in Ads Manager, but seriously, please work smarter, not harder. Or at least work harder on your creative, not pushing buttons inside of Ads Manager, right? You still are going to have to work hard to grow a business. To give you some proof, here is an account where we made over $1 million in ads over 3 months at a very nice return. The targeting had zero interest or lookalikes, which is why I wanted to share with you why broad is better for your business. All right, before we dive into why broad is better, I wanted to say howdy. Haven't done this for a while if you've been watching the channel, but if you have not and you're new here, just want to let you know that I'm Aaron, and alongside my business partner Christian, we have been building businesses since 2015. We focus exclusively on clothing brands, are nearing $100 million in total revenue generated for people like you. We do our absolute best to give y'all the type of content that is only charged for in courses. So we make sure that you hit that subscribe button because we drop new content every single week. Okay, so number three, what is most important here? Why broad is better? I did this one before and I think it would be helpful to do again. So I'm going to draw this out for you and also share screen inside of Ads Manager as references as well. Remember, I am a marketer, not an artist. Okay, so judgment should not be made in the comments, or leave a comment. I don't know, helps YouTube algorithm, but let's go ahead. Okay, so broad targeting, why does it work? Why does interest targeting not work? So this circle represents all of the people who would ever buy from you at any given time. The law that explains why people are able to purchase and at any given time, what is that number, right? And especially, and this number is broken down to like purchases that are $100, $200, $300 or less, right? Or even more so impulse buys. At any given time, an audience, 3% of them are willing to buy right now. So what that means is that if your audience size is 100 million, you have 3% of those people that you could go after that actually are able in the market, willing to purchase from you to buy something. Facebook is so good at its job that it will find those people. But when you go into interest targeting, you go into smaller pockets, right? So maybe you're going after 1 million person audience and you got 3% here. And this assumes that this 3%, if I could draw it here, that this 3%, you could reach the full million person audience. Well, you probably can't because you don't have enough budget or your creative isn't good enough. So there's another factor there. Same thing for lookalikes. It's taking all of the data from people who have made other decisions on your brand and then extrapolating that out to find more people like them. Well, if you don't have any purchases, and you have very little ads to carts, and then you create a lookalike of that, you're losing out on a large percentage of people who could actually buy. So let me explain this in a way that I think will also make a little bit more sense. When you have an audience that is a large audience, that data makes sense for Facebook, and Facebook is able to go and find more people like them. But if you are teaching Facebook to go after add to carts or view contents, it's gonna find people to add to cart or view content. So if you go after and say, Facebook, I want you to create a lookalike of view content or add to carts, and then I'm gonna go for purchases, that you can see how there would be a disconnect there. Facebook found people to add to cart, not people to purchase. And then if you don't have enough purchases with enough data to make all of this make sense, then they still won't be able to find your person. So you're narrowing that audience to even a smaller amount. Now we're going after maybe 20 or 30,000 people, and 3% of those people could buy if they got the right ad to the right message to the right person at the right time, right? So now you have a really small chance, and it's why most people don't actually make money on Facebook. Most people have no clue. I would say 90% of people have no clue what it takes to get a customer to make a purchase. But really, it's quite simple. We're gonna talk about that in the rest of the video. But why broad works is because it gives you a larger amount of people to run an ad to, and we'll talk about that in a little bit later of as far as like what it actually looks like, but you get a larger pool of people that you go after. Now, you could say that the audience pool is 100 million in the US or like 30 million in Canada or the UK. That doesn't matter It's just you need to give Facebook free range to go after your potential target market. And why broad is better? It targets based off of the actual ad, not based off of an audience. Now, we do want to narrow it down by age and gender and location, because the last thing you want to do is go after people in the US when you only sell in the UK, and going after men when you only go after women. So let's figure out the geographics and the age and the gender. Let's do that. But then we can use the ad to do the targeting. I'll explain a little bit more about this. I know I'm saying later, but I wanted to give a visual concept of what this is. And also I want to show a visual concept of targeting here. So I want to, let me pull this up for you guys and show you inside of Ads Manager here. As you can see here, we have one that has 5,000 purchases, $21 cost per purchase. We spent $116,000 over that 3-month period. Spent some other stuff as well, so 176 in total. Just that one campaign made over $700,000. But let's look at the one that actually had the most, or like one of the most. This was a sale for Judy Blue. If you're familiar with Judy Blue or in the boutique world, you understand this. But most importantly, we did do manual placements at the time. Suggest not that anymore, but let's look here. You will see that there are no custom audiences. There are no saved audiences. It is 20 to 64 year old women. There is nothing else. That's it. This is broad. It's wide open. Our audience size was 99 to 116 million, and we didn't even come close to touching that. I think total, we reached 1 million people across the whole account. So less than 10% of the whole audience size that we could have went after. Frequency was like a 4 or 5 over that 3-month period. Okay, so broad targeting is done through the creative. So the image or video, the copy, the headline, your website, that is done through all of the targeting there. One of the reasons that interest targeting or lookalikes will not work as well is because there's this crazy little thing called iOS 15 where people opted in or opted out based off of if they wanted to be tracked, which means that most people, I think at this point, like 70% of people, 80% of people opted out of being tracked online, which means less data for the platform. So what do we need to do to make it smarter? We need to give it more data. So running broad advertising actually gives it more data to make a decision. And once it starts to see what works, it will throw it and it will find more and more people. And as you increase budget, it will get smarter and smarter. All right, so this is pretty straightforward. I'm going to show you the inside of Ads Manager to show you that it really is working and how we set up our ads. Okay, so this is the last 30 days. This is a brand that's going on. As you can see, we got a DCT that is going on. So dynamic creative ads, this is broad. So let's go ahead and look at here, $32 purchases. We got some other stuff going for some live selling, other things going on here as well. So we have an app and use comment sold. So if you're a live seller, then that may make sense for you. Everything else, we really don't even do any retargeting. So 7-day click, but as you can see, we're at broad new arrivals, kind of 11 at this point. It is Advantage Plus placements. Now we switch to that, 21 to 64 years old, women. The only thing we've done is actually exclude, which I wouldn't necessarily suggest for you unless you have a ton of data. We just have a ton of data. And so we're just going after new customers. The clients care more about new customers than they do about anything else. And it's something that we're going back and forth with right now. But honestly, we would not normally do this. We're just happen to be doing it for them, which is why I would say that this is quote unquote an elevated cost per purchase. We are in the J month, so we are in July. So the cost per purchase is a little bit higher. However, still very, very good. This one in particular, right, our V10 had $16.99 purchases. Average is $32. Return is 2.1 here. Okay, and then here's another one that's going on right now. We have a top of funnel DCT that's going on. This is a site-wide type sale. Cost per purchase pretty low. As you can see here, last 30 days, we spent $37,000. Again, all broad, age, gender. We actually have it plused out, 65 plus, because a lot of the people here are, I think, older women. So we have to hit those 75 plus year old women. All right, so those are just some examples of what's actually working. It is broad targeting. They are just wide open targeting. Okay, so before we jump into Ads Manager and I show you how to set up an effective clothing store ad, if you are a clothing store who is looking for more personalized help, or maybe you just have a ton of questions about whether or not you should hire an agency or consultant or really even go that route, most of the time you honestly shouldn't. But to help you scale your brand, you can schedule a 45-minute free strategy session. It is free. but the spots are limited. So we'll dive into how to build a profitable clothing brand and share with you the exact strategy we use to help brands grow to $1 million plus per month. So all you need to do, check out the link in the description down below, schedule your call. We'll see you on the other side. Okay, so enough with the results. I know you want to know how to build this for yourself. Let's build some winning clothing store ads. So for this, there are tons of other videos I want to point to for you to go watch on complete setup from start to finish for the ads. But I want to give you a glimpse in this video of what it would take, because it honestly is, I don't know, you can time it. 1 to 2 minutes to set up this campaign. Very, very simple. Now there's a couple of buttons you do need to make sure that you push. So pay attention. And there's some things that are more important than the ads to make this successful that I'm going to talk about here in a second. But the actual setup, right here, very easy to walk through Ads Manager. Go ahead and click the green button, hit create. We're doing sales. Go ahead and click continue. We're gonna do Advantage Plus shopping or manual. I'm gonna choose manual as an option here. They're eventually gonna probably only give us an option for Advantage Plus, hopefully not, but whole nother conversation. You can label it however you would like. I typically like to do it as DCT or broad or 01 or anything like that. Just let us know that we are going after new customers. And depending on the size of your brand, we should always be going after new customers. And this is really the only campaign you need to set up. Okay, so you scroll on down, Advantage Plus Budget, that is on. It used to be called CBO or Campaign Budget Optimization. It means that it's gonna distribute the budget across multiple ad sets if you have them. Daily budget, set it to whatever you'd like. A nice healthy budget is $100 a day. 50 you could get by, 30 is okay. Anything less than that, probably just boost a post, but that's just our suggestion. So go ahead and skip forward here. Go ahead and hit next. Website and shop, this is something that we've been testing out. You could try this if you would like. So Facebook shop, Instagram shop, your website, and it's just find the best place for somebody to make a purchase. I think it's a good place for you to automatically make this an option. They are pushing it. If not, if you don't have any of those things set up, then go ahead and hit the website. So website and shop, very simple. Now this is the button to turn on. A lot of people scroll over like, what the heck is dynamic creative? You will see it here in a second, but go ahead and turn it on. This allows us to create one ad set with multiple ads instead of what people used to do, which is one campaign, one ad set, five different ads, right? But with this, we have one campaign, one ad set, one ad with multiple ads inside of it. So it looks very clean from that perspective. Okay, so I'm gonna leave it on. Start date, don't change anything. Age, gender, location. Again, change this based off of what you know. So I'm gonna do this, say 23 to 45 year old women. You can change it to whatever your audience is. Yes, you do have an audience. Please do not say both people are audiences. You have one over the other. Advantage Plus placements, go ahead and hit next. Our audience size is pretty good. Make sure ad preview is on. Label this whatever it'd be. So this could be like new arrivals, V12 for us. Make sure you collect the Instagram page, Facebook page, Instagram page is set up. We also wanna make sure that you select some images. We suggest 3 to 4 images or videos. Make sure that they are very similar. So if you're gonna test graphics, test graphics. If you're gonna test videos. If you're gonna test UGC, test UGC. We used to suggest all of those into one ad. That is not the best practice anymore, because you really don't get a true test of what is actually better. A video is gonna cost more to reach more people, but it could have a better cost per purchase. An image is gonna reach a lot more people and could have a great cost per purchase, but we should really be comparing apples to apples. So pick graphics. I'm gonna choose 3 here. Again, 3 graphics, 2 headlines. So hello, buy this. And add another text option, buy this one. Same thing for the headlines. This is a great deal, this is a better deal. And then at that point, you need to make sure you have your website in there. What it's gonna do is it's gonna take the 3 images, it's gonna take the 2 headlines, the 2 primary texts, and it's gonna create a combination of all of those to figure out the best winning ad, and then that is gonna be an ad that works. Otherwise, it's gonna be 3 times 2 times 2, right? So 3 times 2 is 6. Times 2 is 12. You actually created 12 different ads inside of here right now. One campaign, one ad set, 12 ads are sitting right here. You just created 12 ads. Can you believe that? Make sure your tracking is turned on. I know a lot of things are moving to conversion API. We're gonna get rid of offline events, stuff like that. So this may no longer be as effective depending on when you're watching this video, but if it is, make sure the website tracking is turned on. Make sure that if you do have an app or anything, if it's an option, make sure everything green is a go. Give yourself a double like check through, make sure everything looks good, hit publish, that's it. All right, time, you can stop the time there. See how long it took you. But the point is, it's very simple to set up, a lot easier than people think, and then maintaining it, Seriously, so easy. I know this is going over how to build the ad. This is the easiest part, honestly. The areas I want to make sure that you really pay attention to before you build the ads are the following. So your audience research. Who is your audience? Male or female, age, gender, location? Find those things. Really dive into their aspirational identity. Your copywriting. Spend time writing copy. Use ChatGPT. We have videos all about ChatGPT, how to use it, prompts, everything on using it to grow your clothing store. Please use that. Please do not just go in there and be like,
hey, buy my stuff. My boutique's amazing. My street brand's the coolest. I'm amazing.
No, do not do that. Please spend time on your copy because it will help with the convert. The next thing, great content creation. Make sure that your images and videos really stand out. If you want the swipe file, we created something on a tool called Foreplay. It's a swipe file. You can just browse through all the things that we've saved that are really good ads that you can just copy. It's like the Facebook ads library, but on and they never disappear. The last thing that you have to pay attention to is the offer. If it is not a good offer and you are a new brand, nobody is gonna buy. I don't care how good the video is. It's gonna be a lot harder. Give me an amazing deal. If you wanted some inspiration, go watch like some Sham Wow or some guy selling knives at 12 o'clock in the morning. Those are the people who can sell. They have some crazy offers. Take some ideas from them. All right, so once you are able to knock out the previous four things I mentioned, your ads will be in the top 1% of clothing brands, and I can promise you that because my guess is, before you watch this video, if you ran Facebook ads, it has either been boosted or you didn't focus on any of the four things that I just mentioned, or you probably just interest targeting. All right, wishing you all nothing but success right now. And if you like this video on Facebook ads, then you're going to love this video on what it takes to take your brand to $10,000 plus per month on only 10 hours per week. Yes, that is possible. Go click this video right here. Hope you guys have a great rest of your day. P.S. Make sure you subscribe. We'll talk to you soon.